After more than a decade of no missions after the Huygens probe landed and took a picture of the surface of Titan, we finally got a new approved NASA mission that is planning to land another probe on Titan. The Dragonfly spacecraft and lander were proposed in 2017, but this year, in 2019, it was approved, and NASA is currently working on creating the whole thing. Dragonfly should be done by 2026 and launched into space, and it should arrive on Titan by the year 2034, which means that the trip would be longer than the amount of time it was needed to create the spacecraft. Still, this doesn't actually mean that it will for sure land in 2034, because often space missions get delayed, and by a lot. And there is also the risk factor of the launch being unsuccessful, or the landing on Titan could be unsuccessful, as a lot of space missions with landers and rovers do not go well. So yeah, considering the long time span and the risks involved, we shouldn't get all hyped up for this mission, as it could be a failure. But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't take a look at what could happen, as it is the most exciting in-development mission currently. The Dragonfly spacecraft will first have to successfully launch into space, and from Earth, go to Saturn, which is a trip around 1.4 billion kilometers long, which is 7 times longer than the average distance between Earth and Mars. So it is obviously a very long trip, and it is much lengthier to deliver things that far away. So it should take Dragonfly around 8 years to reach Saturn, almost a whole decade, going at the speed which is faster than a shot bullet. Because Titan has similar conditions to the conditions which were present on Earth before life around 4 billion years ago, this lander will be used to study the composition of the soil and the atmosphere. And with that info, we can get a more accurate picture of how life began on Earth. Now, when the rocket finally reaches Titan, it will release the Rotorcraft lander, which will be falling down gently with a parachute. And that's right, this is actually a Rotorcraft lander, which will be able to lift off the surface like a drone and land on many areas. The Rotorcraft will have 8 rotors and will be able to fly at the speed of 36 kilometers per hour, and will be able to go up to 4 kilometers into the air, which is very impressive. It will allow the Rotorcraft to travel huge distances and see many different terrains present on Titan, and see the composition of each area, which are many kilometers apart. Now, the reason Dragonfly will be able to fly this efficiently is because of Titan itself, which has 13% the gravity of the Earth, has very little winds, and has a dense atmosphere. All of these factors allow the Rotorcraft to be many times more efficient than it would on the Earth. It's crazy how much less power is needed to achieve flight on Titan compared to Earth. Dragonfly is also 450 kilograms heavy, which is 2 times less than the Curiosity rover on Mars is. But considering that it will be able to fly, that could allow it to see more diverse areas and at that, even be more efficient than Curiosity. Rotorcraft will be landing in Shangri-La area of Titan. It is a huge area with dunes composed of a dark material. It is a safe area to land in, as it is a plain. Now, Dragonfly will be designed to withstand cold temperatures present on Titan, which are around minus 180 Celsius, and it will be able to withstand the radiation that will be present due to Titan not having a magnetic field. The Rotorcraft will be powered by a battery which will be recharged by a generator which can convert the heat from a decaying atom into electricity. After a single recharge, it could travel tens of kilometers into the distance. Dragonfly will also carry 2 spectrometers, 1 sensor, a drill for the soil, panoramic cameras, and a microscope. All of that load will be able to reveal precisely what is going on Titan, and we can finally see if it can bear single-celled organisms and see the chemistry of the soil. The Rotorcraft is planned to fly and explore Shangri-La area, and later on it will fly to Selk Crater, a big 80-kilometer long crater which has evidence of organic compounds and flowing liquid water in the past. So, as we can see, the Dragonfly mission is really ambitious, and the most exciting one right now, because it is set to explore Titan, a moon of Saturn far away which has lots of things going on its surface. And this rotorcraft, if successful, will finally be able to bring images from another very lively world.